Well, the calendar may say it's spring, but long-range models continue to show significant snows falling across a big portion of the country straight into the first week of April. And along with that heavy snow threat, we're also tracking around a severe weather coming your way late in the day on Sunday, and that'll also continue into your Monday. We'll have a detailed look coming your way next. Welcome back, everybody, to the Weather Nerds YouTube channel. I'm your host, Greg Majeski, your personalized weatherman, making a difference one subscriber at a time. As we take a look at what's going on currently here across the nation, well, we're in store for some pretty wet weather across the southeast as we're watching this area of low pressure tracking across. That'll bring that wet weather along with some pretty hefty thunderstorms expected down along the Florida Peninsula. And out on the West Coast, we've got a cold front moving in, and this is the storm system that'll eventually develop and reemerge into our severe weather threat as we head into Sunday and into Monday. And if you would like to be alerted and have some personalized severe weather coverage, all you gotta do is give me a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel, make sure you hit that notification bell so you're alerted on when that broadcast begins. And if you like this forecast, if you like this report, please leave me a comment down below. I always like to respond to folks' feedback, and this service is for you. So we got plenty to get into for this edition. Let's go ahead and take a look at the latest models. So one thing you're going to definitely notice as we take a look at that jet stream that kind of drives the weather across the country, it's going to be very active. You're going to see some wild fluctuations there. So as we go ahead and wrap up the month of March, it's going to keep our weather pretty busy. So let's go ahead and get on out of here. Let's go ahead and watch what happens here as we watch this storm system out here on that west coast. You see that little low there off the coast there. It's going to cause the buckle in that jet stream as we go into early next week. So as we go into the weekend, you see that big dip there as it dives down into the southwest. You see in the winds kind of rotating around. And it looks like the best dynamics, I feel, for the potential for tornado activity is probably going to be on Monday as compared to on Sunday. But Monday looks like that'll be when the storm system will potentially be at its strongest, the way it's looking currently with the models. And then this big trough is going to kind of shift off toward the east. And as it does so, it's going to allow a pretty good dive of some cold air. It's going to come down here out of Canada here across the middle of the country. So right through here, we'll see a nice little dive of some colder weather and briefly milder weather up along the east coast out ahead of that trough. And then that trough's going to begin to slowly but surely pull on out. Nice little dip in the jet stream there going into Thursday. We're talking about the 28th. And then our attention will again quickly shift back to the west coast as we've got another dive in the jet stream coming in there as we wrap up this model run going into Saturday and going into Sunday. So we're going to have to watch that one closely as we go into the first couple days in April to see if we get another round of severe weather that could potentially fire off as we go into the next month. So now what you're going to be looking at here, we're going to be tracking the moisture. That's the dew point that kind of measures the amount of moisture in the air. And you notice we've got abundant moisture across the southeast, definitely wrapping up into a wet and rainy Friday into Saturday. And then we're going to watch this moisture kind of surge out of this approaching cold front system out off the west coast. So watch what happens here as we go forward in through the weekend. As we watch that moisture along the southeast, a lot of moisture there with that storm system spreading some rains up along the Carolinas. But then we watch that moisture feed start to come back up across Texas and Oklahoma. As we watch that developing storm system throughout the day on Sunday, and you get the kind of a clash. You got a drier air mass from the west, kind of running into that milder and more moisture-laden air mass out ahead of it. And that's what's going to fire off those initial storms late in the day on Sunday. And this will begin to push off toward the east. So you see the low pressure there starting to form there across portions of western Kansas, a very sharp dividing line between that drier air and that moist, warmer air out ahead of it. And that's what's going to fire off those thunderstorms. And those are going to begin to push off toward the east. It really gets pretty moisture-laden, especially as we go throughout the day on Monday along the Texas Gulf Coast and up through Arkansas as that storm system pushes off toward the east. And then it'll move into the southeast, moving into portions of Alabama and Mississippi. You see the higher moisture content there. They were in the kind of the bluish gray color there across portions of Alabama and the Florida Peninsula, pretty moisture laden air. And then the storm system begins to lose its punch as it pushes off toward the east and kind of you know, loses a little bit of its vigor as it approaches the East Coast. So that's what we're going to be watching here very shortly. And I'll back this up once again. We'll watch that storm system develop, especially as we go throughout the day on Sunday. So watch that very closely as you got a nice little clash of the drier, colder air moving into that moisture, warmer air, moist laden, warmer air out ahead of it. And that's what's going to fire off those thunderstorms. And that'll be pushing off to the east again for Sunday and Monday into early next week. So let's go take a look at the precipitation and see how that's tracking across the country. So we're going to focus in here first as we go into the weekend with this rain across the southeast. It's going to be moving up the eastern seaboard. In fact, could dump some pretty decent snows up in areas in Maine. And then we'll focus our attention on the West Coast system that'll be moving into the areas of the Intermountain West before it pulls out of the plains to set off that severe weather and active weather late in the day on Sunday and into your Monday. So let's go ahead and take a closer look again, watching that moisture across the southeast, a wet and rainy Friday wrapping up. That'll kind of linger into your Saturday morning briefly across the southeast, but the bulk of the rain will be focusing up into the mid-Atlantic, and the snows will be increasing up across areas of Maine, and that will last most of the day on Saturday. So it's going to be pretty snowy up into the extreme areas of the northeast as the rain begins to slowly clear the eastern seaboard. Then as we go into your Sunday, we're going to watch this evolution of this big dip of the jet stream as we watch this low pressure begin to pull on out. We'll start to fire off some thunderstorms. You notice there across portions of Kansas and Oklahoma. That'll be the initial round of thunderstorms that could potentially be severe there. Notice the snow spreading across the northern portion of this. Again, there's a winter storm element of this from Minnesota stretching back over into Montana as this low pulls on out, and we're getting those thunderstorms to fire up there again late in the day across Kansas and stretching back in toward Texas as we head into the early evening hours. So this is roughly about 9, 10 o'clock, so getting kind of late there. And as this pulls off toward the east, those thunderstorms will continue to fire up with the daytime heating on Monday as that low pulls up to the north, still getting that wraparound snows across the areas of the Dakotas back toward Nebraska. And those storms will get pretty hefty by late in the afternoon across portions of Arkansas, back toward areas of Louisiana and extreme eastern Texas as this pushes off toward the east. So looks like a pretty stormy night across the southeast from Missouri back toward Louisiana as we're coming up toward the midnight hour, and these storms will be pushing into Mississippi. As I always say, nighttime storms are always bad, so please make sure you have your weather radios ready to go for alerts should you get severe thunderstorm warnings or even tornado warnings in your area through the overnight hours Monday and into Tuesday. And looking still a pretty decent squall line there across portions of east, portions of Tennessee, back across the Mississippi-Alabama line, and that'll be pushing off toward the east throughout the day on Tuesday. Still looking at the potential for some severe weather there across Alabama and the Florida panhandle throughout the day on Tuesday. And then as we go into late in the day on Tuesday, into the evening, those storms should begin to lose their punch, and things begin to settle on down as we watch that storm system push off toward the east there, looking a little wet there as we go in throughout the day on Wednesday, or just along the eastern seaboard. Notice back on the west coast, though, we got another storm system there moving in there across portions of Northern California, bringing some more heavy snows across the Sierra Nevada once again as that storm system begins to move on in there and bringing some snows for the Intermountain region. And still got that hung up area of low pressure along the eastern seaboard. It's going to be really slow to kind of clear on out there as we go into the end, the last few days of March. And we got a little weak storm system there in the middle of the country, setting up some more snows and some more rains there across portions of Nebraska. That will be late in the day on your Friday on the 30th. And as that storm system out of the west begins to pull inland again, that's the one that's got a little vigor to it as it, that big dip in the jet stream there as we go into late in the day on Sunday, going into your Easter Sunday. And then we'll watch out and see if that will provide some potential for some heavy snows across areas of Denver once again and Nebraska. And then we'll have to watch as we go into Monday and Tuesday going into the first and second on whether we're going to get some potential severe weather outside of the European 10-day look here, the way it's looking currently. The winter side of this storm is going to start off initially with some snows across areas of Iowa and into portions of Illinois and southern Wisconsin, as that's going to quickly move off toward the east. And as it does so, it's going to hook up with some of that moisture coming in from the south, and it's going to dump some very heavy snows there across the interior sections of New England from New York State and into portions of Maine. Some very heavy snows there, localized amounts over a foot, not out of the question there. You're going to also notice the snows increasing out on the west coast, getting some more snows up there in the Sierra Nevada once again and spreading across the interior sections as we see, again, that explosion of snow kind of piling up from Minnesota and back to the Dakotas as that next storm system on the Sunday and Monday starts to take shape there across the middle of the country and dumping some pretty hefty snows into that area as well. Localized areas over a foot, not out of the question, across portions of southern Minnesota, getting into portions of South Dakota as well, the eastern portions there, and even some moisture down into areas of Nebraska as that snow will kind of continue up into Canada. And as we look at the rest of the 10-day, we get some more snows piling on once again across the Intermountain region. And you're talking about feet of snow. You notice that white, bright white area there across California. Yeah, that's it when we see, you know, upwards of 2 feet plus across the Sierra Nevada once again as that another storm system plows in there. And we even had some more snows up across areas of, say, the eastern portions of Canada and stretching back into Maine once again. So a big chunk of the country is going to see some significant snows falling over the next 10 days. And the American GFS model continues that trend into the first week as well. Well, it is definitely snow time for a big portion of the country, but it's also going to be showtime when it comes to severe weather as we go into your Sunday late in the day and going into your Monday. So if you would like to have some personal live severe weather coverage, all you got to do is go ahead and give me a thumbs up and subscribe to this channel. Go hit that notification bell so you're alerted on that broadcast. And if you like what you saw with this report, please leave me a comment down below. I do appreciate the feedback. But if you do want to get those alerts for nice severe weather coverage, because I got all my latest slides ready to go, please subscribe to the channel. All right, that's it for now. You guys enjoy your upcoming weekend. We'll look forward to serving you again. Until then, you guys take it easy, stay safe, and we'll see you on the next report. Until then, bye-bye for now.